Hello dogs, Lildawg right here, right now, and it is freaking 3:20 in the freaking morning. Mostly because I had a busy day yesterday, and I fell asleep at around 6:30. And so, judging by how long I sleep, it makes sense that I woke up at like 3 o'clock in the freaking morning. I have no internet at the moment, for whatever reason. The internet has been very trashy today. And yeah, we're back with the Lildawgian Empire, which we are looking kinda beefy. Also, we have some territory over here. Some point, I want to get through more research. Get to at least 45. Yeah, yesterday was my mother's birthday, and I mowed the lawn. I had to walk to the store to get her a gift, because I can't drive yet. And that was a fun walk. And later on, we went out to a local place called Pizza Man. It's a pizza place, and it's really good. And so, alright. Okay, so we now know what's going on, and oh my gosh, North Korea, you're doing pretty good. Yeah, this is the territory they currently own. And we currently border them. That's fun. Got me something to drink right now. We're getting closer and closer to AD as time goes on. Thule. I didn't even know this was an actual civilization. The civilization of Thule. Probably some Native American tribe I never heard of. Poor Texas. They got wiped by the Toltec. Anyways, I think this is going to be the last episode, to be honest. Mostly because I'm getting bored of this series. It was fun seeing all the random stuff, now that I've explored what's going on and everything. It's getting to a point where it's not fun. And don't worry. The last thing we're gonna do is kill North Korea. That is a given. We have to do that to ensure our dominance over this world. And fighting North Korea is gonna be difficult because they have land scattered everywhere. This is the Empire of North Korea. You may not like it, but this is what peak performance looks like. Oh my god. Yeah. We are gonna need to be building large armies. Big armies. The biggest armies. To go on and fight North Korea. This is gonna take a while because I'm hiring a buttload. I'm gonna ask them. And I'm gonna ask them to all gather around Salem. Oh, it's because I don't have enough money. I was wondering why I couldn't hire that many troops. It's because I didn't have the money to hire troops. Yeah, we're just gonna be dumping some money into building an army. Take on North Korea. They're going to have a lot of troops, too. In fact, if I remember correctly, they have some pretty populated provinces. I think our best bet would be to go after those populated provinces first. Alright. That's around another 1,000 right there. Alright. Alright, I think we're ready. Oh yeah, that war. All right. are about to go to war. It's going to be a very interesting war. Oh, Communist China's here, and they're getting their butts handed to them. Yeah, we have several fascist nations over here in China. Interesting. And we have like 50 Chinas like normal. That's honestly nothing unusual. We're always going to have like 50 Chinas. I'm gonna be focused on, like, the other side of the world, so I don't really care about the Bahamas. Alright, so my troops are leaving the port in Detroit. We are going to be waiting for quite a bit while we wait for our military to get to Japan. I just realized it's my freaking... Give me a moment. Alright, I was just making sure my microphone was actually... recording, because I just plugged it in moments ago because it had been unplugged for a bit, mostly because I took a week. If you don't know, I took last week off. I just wanted a week off to get my head straight and and so I didn't really need my microphone all that much. And so it was unplugged. We may have a clash between Arizona and... Oh no, maybe not. In fact, Wozteck and Arizona seem to be working together. Interesting. Jeez. I never thought I'd see there where we'd be fighting a North Korean superpower. Like, that's something you rarely hear of. Oh, they just took out North Korea's military access through... They're taking out North Korea's military access through Lu. Why is it called Lu? I don't know. Well, I feel like that was a pretty pointless war. You didn't even frickin' take anything. Oh no, you... Oh... Makes more sense, actually. I might get me some breakfast in a moment. I'm a little hungry. I have to be honest though, when am I not hungry? It's taken so long for this army to arrive in frickin' Japan. Then again, it has to travel all the way around Alaska and stuff. Fun for it. I'm surprised I'm not seeing any further into China. I think that shows you how freaking massive Asia is. Oh yeah, and I figured out how the randomizer actually properly works. So, get your randomizer working. Your economy and population have to be the same. That's your first step. Your second step is you have to make sure random fill is on. That way everyone will have enough territory to actually conquer stuff and actually make money. Because there's this weird bug with the economy in randomized games, where if you do not do that exact requirements, you're going to be making no money, and in fact, you're going to be in inflation for whatever reason, and you're going to always be at zero gold, and you can't do freaking anything. And waiting's not going to help, because your economy won't rise by itself. And I don't remember correctly, but I believe trying to set your, like, goods and investments will actually take away from your money, and it actually, so even then, you're gonna be losing people in development. And so, randomized games, that's one of the first things that need to be fixed, because from what I can tell, the developer has not abandoned this game yet. He's just not working on the bug stuff. And I think he will get to it at some point. But for now, this is what we got. We have to deal with it. That's just an unfortunate factor of life. Alright. Alright, so we actually have some pretty decent population to hire from. Alright, we're ready. This is gonna be one heck of a war. We'll be right back. Would you look at that? How the mighty have fallen. North Korea has been completely defeated. Now, let's check our casualties. Oh yeah, both sides have taken a crap ton of casualties. 39,000 casualties in total. I've taken around 18,000 today. I've taken around 20,000. Alright. The one thing I want to do is strip North Korea of their Japanese possessions. And then I'm going to attempt to strip them of their Chinese possessions. Probably not going to get all of them. Actually, I might. Alright, so North Korea has been stripped of all of their Japanese and Chinese possessions. Now then. Alright, I think that'll do it. We've stripped North Korea of pretty much most of their power. And make it official. Bam! Oh, how the mighty have fallen. They're probably not going to be too happy with me. Oh, boy. So anyways, that's going to do it for this episode. And for this series, pretty much. I'm probably going to end this episode off with the... probably going to end this series off with a time-lapse, which I'm going to probably upload today along with this to get my double upload out of the way. But for the most part, I'm pretty much done with the series. Like, I've gotten what I wanted to do done. I'm first in the world. I've defeated the next most powerful, which was North Korea out of all people, which that is... the highlight. This is the highlight of the entire series right here, North Korea being number one. So, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll probably see you in the next series, whatever one that's gonna be. I have an idea of what I'm gonna do, but I have not gotten everything planned out yet, so just be patient with me on this one. Alright, I'll see you in the next one. Bye!